I think for us coming all over into New Zealand in the beginning, as far as the ODIs are concerned, we knew it was going to be a tough challenge. I think the key for us, it boiled down to how we prepared. I think everyone that contributed to make sure that we get here early enough to give ourselves a chance. I think it was shown with the ODIs, the first leg, how the players adapted to that because they had enough time on the conditions and the way they played. So for us as a team, it was a very successful tour because we came here knowing that we need to win to give ourselves a chance to qualify automatically for the World Cup. So after achieving that, the first hurdle, well, everyone contributed in the camp. I mean, the betting, that has always been our headache, the consistency we saw now there. When it happens, what the results can be, because bowlers always set up games for us. So that gave us a good boost, and each and everyone contributing in the camp. And the consistency that we saw overall was very good. Players were well managed on the tour. Medical work extremely hard around the clock to make sure that we had a fully fit squad to be able to compete against a team that plays well on their conditions. And to achieve the result the way we achieved, I think the players played exceptionally well. They deserve a round of applause for everything and the effort done, because no one has done what they did to New Zealand on their home soil. So for them it's a first, and it's a first for New Zealand. So for us, we take a chip onto our shoulders and say to them, well done, ladies. I think going into T20s now, we knew that with the format that is changing now, it's going to be tough. We're playing again against a team that is explosive. I mean, they've shown the way they can play. And for us, you could see that they were quickly off the blocks. And it's a team that put us under pressure very early from the first game. So we always had to catch up. And you know, when you're playing catch-up cricket, it's always tough. Because for us, it was also important to give everyone within the squad an opportunity to play, and also to see how combinations are going forward into the World Cup. So we also didn't want to lose sight of that as a team, to make sure that, yes, at the end of the day, you play to win. Each and every player that went there, they went to put in a performance, but it wasn't to be. We were outplayed by a very good side that played on home soil. And we took a lot of positives out there. We see how the youngsters went. Some of them took the opportunity, some learned from that. And some of our seniors were also had to manage to make sure that come the World Cup, everyone is ready. So I think overall for us, as far as the T20s, there's a lot we're taking with us. Well played to New Zealand, the deservingly winners of the series. And for us, there's a lot we're taking into Australia. Now we know that we've got two more warm-up games there to make sure that we're ready for the first game against England. So overall, each and everyone from management all around, it has been a great tour, very tough and challenging here and there. But overall, I think we're coming out of the, with the full squad again to make sure that everyone had a game time on these conditions. So come the World Cup now, each and every player know what is required, because we tried a lot of things. We know where we are as a squad and what we need to do. I think also it gave us a side, because none of us actually came to New Zealand before. So of the venues that we played, will be some of the World Cup venues. So that also gave us in-depth analysing the conditions to see what could happen, what is needed. So it was a good exercise overall when we have to come back next year. So the team coming back will be better prepared as to what is coming or what to expect of the conditions. But overall, I think as a team, we actually got what we needed. And we know that with the youngsters now, that they got an opportunity to play with the experienced players. They've seen what needs to happen. I mean, when you're better, that's what you need to do. That's how you put up your hand. As a bowler, there's a certain expectation and skill that you need to execute on this skill. And to be consistent in the team, performances needs to lead the way. So overall, everybody understands it's great competition. It's a group of youngsters that we're growing for the future. I believe that 2021, we're going to see some of them coming of age now and starting to show us what they're capable of, which is very good. And they're going to push their seniors now to make sure that the seniors keep stay on their toes and keep giving us the performances that we know is expected from them. So if you look at it in twofold, both ODIs and T20s, it was encouraging to see us. Most of the squad, when they be given opportunities in different challenging roles, something that they're not used to, how they actually dealt with the pressure under those conditions. But overall, I think 2021 World Cup will be good for us, and then we'll be better prepared. And if we keep the squad as is and build on what we have now, it can just come. You never know what's going to happen. Regarding Mignon Dupre, there's so much you can say. The word that defines her, if I have to look at how you define a player like that, from where she started, a young kid, she had a very good support structure. I mean, her father has been supporting, being always there for her. He's been the pillar of strength in her life as far as cricket is concerned. I think she's one of those that you can say is a true professional of the game, ambassador for the country, the one that's always giving 200%, willing to help others, going out of her way to also improve her game, not neglecting that. And you can see the maturity now that over the years, what she's learned, how she's going about it, even every day, how she pushes youngsters to get better. and make sure that each and everyone in the squad is attended to. But overall, and even you can see with the performances, he shows a lot of maturity now. She has become a very key member of the squad going forward. So I think if you look at one person that is well-deserved as far as the 100 T20 cap would be, she's one of those, if you can say, well-deserved. I mean, she'll be the first female player in the country to do that. So for us, that is also showing that the leadership and everyone wants to follow in that and to make sure that they also get there. So she's one of those that has led on and off the field with fitness, performances, you can see. So I think for us, from where we are very blessed to have the talent that we've seen in Mignon Dupreuil and everything and the maturity that she's showing, that she must just continue. We hope that it's going to be many more for her and see the game can actually see what she's capable of as we go along in the latter stages of her career.